I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to introduce a new type of mathematical object called a fraction. And defining a fraction precisely is a significant challenge, and there are many different points of view that one could possibly take. We're going to approach things from a foundational point of view, meaning we're interested in something which has very few prerequisites, and is just based on what we've done so far, starting from natural numbers. Let's introduce the idea that a mathematical object has a certain type. So far we only have natural numbers, and they are of type num, standing for natural number. Here's a summary of the operations that we have so far that are inputting numbers or pairs of numbers and give outputting numbers. We want to introduce new objects called fractions, like 2/3 or this one here. And we want to do this for a number of reasons. First of all, we want to be able to do arithmetic smoothly. So when we have 24 divided by 6 times 15 divided by 5, we know we can rewrite that as 24 times 15 divided by 6 times 5. And the way we are doing arithmetic suggests that we should be able to swap these around, replace it with 5 times 6, and then rewrite this as 24 divided by 5 times 15 divided by 6. However, currently, these are not well-defined operations. We cannot currently divide 24 by 5, nor 15 by 6. So currently, this kind of operation is not defined. There are various approaches to fractions. One of them is to think of a fraction as a part of a whole. So if we represent one, not just with a little stick, but let's say a square, or possibly a circle, then we would represent two as a pair of squares or a pair of circles. And then it's natural to think of 2/3 as representing a part of one. In this case, the red part. That's one way of thinking about what a fraction like 2/3 means. Another way of thinking about it is in terms of the measure of a segment. If we think of one as representing a segment like this, then something like 3 will be represented by a longer segment like that. And then it's natural to think about a shorter segment, perhaps like that one, as being a representation of what 2/3 means. Similarly, if we look at this longer segment, then divided by 2, then we get the fraction 3/2. So that's a derivation of what fractions are connecting with geometry. Another way of thinking about fractions is as an operation. So we think of 2/3 as being an operation that allows us to take 2/3 of something. So here's a collection of things. 2/3 of this collection is this collection. So it's an operator that acts on something to give you something else. Another way of thinking about it is as a ratio or a proportion. For example, 2/3 can be thought of as the ratio or proportion 2 to 3. And we can imagine that by comparing two objects, and the relative sizes of those two objects might be 2 to 3. So there are various possible ways of thinking about fractions, and each one of them has some usefulness and validity, and can be used as a basis for teaching young people. However, when we do mathematics, we want to set things up in such a way so as not to require a prior understanding of geometry. We want something that only depends on what we've already done before. And so we're going to use a slightly different way of thinking about what a fraction is. So here's our main definition. A fraction is an ordered pair, m, n, of natural numbers. So it's just two natural numbers, one followed by the other, an ordered pair. And we also write this ordered pair in the form m/n. What a fraction is, a mathematical definition. And there's an important notion of equality that occurs with fractions. If we have two fractions, m/n, or we say m/n, and k/L, then these two fractions are declared to be equal precisely when m times l equals n times k. So for example, 2/3 equals 6/9 because 2 times 9 is equal to 3 times 6. And both of those are equal to 4 over 6, and to many other ones. That's a definition of fraction that only depends on our prior understanding of what a natural number is. A fraction is just a pair of natural numbers, which we write m over n. Now, there's a possible confusion here with our earlier notation. And let's make sure we get this straight. So, right now, let's say we have 15 over 5 with this slanted line. That represents for us a fraction. And it's a new type of mathematical object, which we'll call FRA, short for fraction. 15 over 5 with a horizontal line like that, that represents a division. That is a number still in the type num. Okay. So from now on, we're going to be fussy. We're going to distinguish between a horizontal line, which means division of one natural number by another, and the slanted line, which represents fraction for us. Well, now that we have fractions, we can naturally ask how we can do arithmetic with them. That's what we're going to talk about next video. I hope you'll join me. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.